Hello and welcome back to the channel. My name is Peter, and today we're going to be discussing the S&P 500. The stock market is currently on a melt up. We're seeing huge gains over a very, very short period of time. So that's exactly what we're going to discuss in this episode. What can we expect over the next few trading sessions following this huge move up? Is this the beginning of a much larger move up in the markets, or are we due for a short-term correction that could actually bring about some buying opportunities at lower levels? That's what we're going to discuss in this episode. We're going to be looking at the US dollar index. We're going to be taking a look at what's happening on the VIX, on the volatility of the S&P 500. So without further ado, let's get right into it. So we're going to begin with the technicals of the S&P 500. Just a quick reminder of where we are on that long-term chart. That's the price channel that we've been looking at for weeks now, that we were testing throughout this period in January and February, and that we actually recently broke out. And this is exactly what we've been talking about in our videos. Once we get that breakout, it changes everything for the stock market. It's the biggest game changer for the stock market in 2021. And that's exactly what's happening right now. So when you have these types of developments that can lead to some big, powerful moves, and that's exactly what we're getting right now. So let's get in on a shorter term chart. And so this is the 8-hour chart with that same level that we're looking at. This is that long-term price channel resistance that we've just broken out of. And if we zoom into what's happening right now, we're approaching a nice level of resistance. You can see this line right here that I've drawn from the body of these candles capturing all these reactions throughout that uptrend. This is the trend line that we were following when we entered our S&P 500 long trade setup with our members on gameoftrades.net. And now we're coming back up to test this line. This is a strong line of resistance. And if we zoom in just a little bit more on a 4-hour chart and take a look at what's happening with the RSI here, this is the RSI overextended, overbought, and printing nice divergence right here with the price going up, heading into that line of resistance, and the RSI making its way down. Now, normally we don't pay too much attention to RSI divergence on this time frame, but this is very much different. We're looking at RSI divergence on a massively overextended trend. You can see this is on a steady overbought reading, similar to what we had back right here in September. We had that very same type of development, price making huge gains right here and the RSI making its way down whilst overbought. So very, very similar technical structure. Now, before you start shorting the S&P 500 because we're at resistance, that might be a bad idea. And I'm going to show you exactly why. We're going to zoom in to this uptrend as an example right here. And we can actually put a nice little trend line right there capturing these reactions. 1, 2, 3, 4 reactions. 5, a fifth reaction right here. And then we actually had a melt up move through that resistance before eventually failing. So is that the type of move that we can expect right now? That is a possibility. We're currently on a very strong move. So seeing this type of move could definitely be a possibility, and that would provide a nice short entry on a break back down below. That's a false breakout if that happens. Now, I wouldn't recommend that for any beginner trader. This is really for experienced traders trading these types of small breakouts. It's a very quick pump and dump through that resistance level. So we are expecting some type of correction in the short term once this blow off top moves comes to an end. But I do want to clarify, this is a massively bullish development. And we were talking about that throughout this entire period here. If we get a breakout above this level, that changes everything for the stock market. And I know I'm repeating myself, but that's very important to understand. You don't get this type of development every day. Let's zoom out and we can take a look at the last time we had that kind of breakout was back in 1997. And of course, looking forward from that moment, it was a very good time to be in the stock market, perhaps not long term. Looking out 10 years, it wasn't such a good deal being in the stock market, but looking out 2-3 years in the short term, that was a great moment to be in the S&P 500 and an even better moment to be in tech. So we're really seeing a repeat of what was going on right here. Now, staying on this weekly chart, I added one of the indicators that we love using. That's the percentage difference between the price and the 50 moving average. So this is a weekly chart. We're looking at the 50-week moving average. So I added that moving average on this chart here. And basically, this tells you how far away the price is from that blue line. And you can see we're really starting to extend ourselves farther than at any point that we can see on this chart right here. Let's put a horizontal line right there where we currently are. And let's see when the last time we were this overextended over the 50-day moving average. Let's go back further. No tags. The last time was in 1999, right there, where we had a series of those tags. That first tag in 1997, and then a couple others throughout the following years. So definitely some very interesting things that are happening right now. Very exciting times ahead. And I'm going to show you why this trend might not actually come to an end just yet. This is the US dollar currency index. We've been looking at this for a while because the US dollar is a major factor on whether the stock market goes up or down. And I can actually show you that relationship throughout this period as we got that US dollar breakout right there. That was actually a sideways period of consolidation on the S&P 500. I can add the S&P 500 on this chart, and you can see throughout this period right there, that same precise period, it was kind of a grind price action with quite a significant correction right there. But when the dollar really started to reverse that breakout, that's when we broke out and the S&P 500 really started to rally. And of course, that's been pushing precious metals higher. It's been pushing and emerging markets higher. And we are very much prepared for a weak dollar environment with our members on gameoftrades.net, because that's the trade to be in right now. You want to be in assets that go up when the dollar is going down. Crude oil, for example, is breaking out right now, and that might start waking up some sectors like XLE and make them come back from the dead after almost a decade of severe underperformance. And we can quickly add that 200-day moving average, of a significant moving average for the US dollar. And you can see what we got here, a nice false breakout and an impulsive break back down. So that's looking good for the dollar bear market thesis, very similar to some of the developments we had in 2003 right there, 2004 right here. Also a period with particularly easy monetary policies that actually led to the housing bubble. So, and that's when you realize that history kind of repeats itself over and over again, both in the short term and the longer term. You have easy monetary policies, a bubble starts to appear, they need to tighten the policy, and that's when you get the bubble popping. So maybe that next bubble is actually going to be the stock market. That really depends on what happens over the next few months with that breakout that we're seeing right now. But it does look like that's where we're heading. By the way, make sure to drop a like on this video if you haven't already. It helps our videos out massively, and it only takes a couple of seconds. So make sure to hit it as hard as you can. And also subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and you want to learn how to actually profit from the markets, how to actually find opportunities and read price action and combine that with fundamentals. Now I want to take a look at the VIX, because the VIX is getting absolutely crushed right now. It broke through that entire support zone that we were looking at, and so that's really no surprise. We're really in a blow off top move. So the VIX is going to go down, right? The volatility goes up when the market starts to crash, and it goes down when the market is rallying. So all of these big spikes that you see right there, those are corrections in the market. You can see how quickly they happen. So when you've got the S&P 500 melting up, we're clearly in a blow off top type of move, very overextended, and you might be starting to worry about a correction. You don't want to sell all your stocks, but you still want to be protected against short-term volatility. And that's when you can take a hedge trade by going long on the VIX. Despite owning the stock market, we're starting to get into a strong area of support, right? This is where we were trading before the health crisis. And so as soon as the stock market begins to correct, we will see a spike in volatility. Now, again, this is not the type of trade you'll take if you're a beginner. right? This is for expert traders. And the reason for that, and I was discussing that with the members on the site, is because ETFs that track the volatility index tend to go down over time. If we zoom out here on the VIX doesn't go down over time, it goes sideways. But you can't actually buy the VIX. You have to buy an ETF that tracks the volatility, and that ETF is going down over a long period of time. You don't want to be taking long positions and holding them, because that gives you 100% probability of losing your money over time. But you can see that was the type of trade that you could have taken back in September in that melt up that we were talking about, where we saw that blow off top, the RSI divergence on the 4-hour chart, and you had the VIX coming down to this strong level of support right there. Quite a few reactions on that line. It was holding as support. You can take your trade right there at support. Sell at resistance right there. That was a nice level of resistance. And the profits on that trade you put back into your long positions on the S&P 500. And it's as if the correction never happened. And that actually makes you be able to profit from corrections without exiting your long positions. Now, that's about all I wanted to cover in this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, don't hesitate to drop a like and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. In the meantime, good luck on your trading and see you next time.